Hello, Robber Heart. Welcome back for another deep dive into Robber's remarkable role in unlocking the secrets of the seven seas. Today, we'll be suiting up and following the winding currents of Robber history that allowed fearless divers to gradually extend their adventures deeper and farther beneath the waves over the past century. Because, as you'll soon witness, each innovative new application of elastic, flexible rubber compounds opened the door to conquering new underwater realms. From the crude gaskets and air hoses of diving's earliest days to the modern marvels of silicone masks and life-preserving neoprene suits, it was the unique properties and customizability of polymers that allowed us to adapt to the ocean's inhospitable pressures and temperatures. So fill up those tanks and prepare to descend into the rubber-reinforced revolution of scuba as we know it. The tides of diving technology were transformed breath by buoyant breath thanks to these ever-evolving elastomers. In scuba's primordial days before the 1940s, both surface-supply diving helmets and early suits were far too heavy and cumbersome to allow much meaningful underwater mobility or exploration. Copper and brass helmets used stiff leather gaskets for neck seals, while suits were canvas affairs that also relied on leather cuffs and seals that were hardly watertight. Rubber did make limited cameos in basic heat-cured hoses, channeling air from surface pumps, and perhaps some rudimentary valve gaskets. But the days of effortlessly gliding weightless through the depths seemed an impossible pipe dream. That all changed in the 1930s when aquatic explorers Jacques Cousteau and Émile Gagnon patented their revolutionary aqualung, the first truly self-contained underwater breathing apparatus or scuba system. Their deceptively simple regulator design incorporated several modest but crucial rubber components. The Cousteau-Gagnon catalyst first were the flexible medium-grade natural rubber hoses connecting that first regulator's valve system to both the air tank and mouthpiece. Rubber's ability to remain supple under pressure while channeling life-giving air was vital. Its inherent air retention qualities were also put to use in the inflatable rubber bladder that became the precursor to modern buoyancy compensator jackets. The progenitor of scuba had turned to rubber to provide critical sealing and adjustable buoyant assistance. The progenitor of scuba had turned to rubber to provide critical sealing and adjustable buoyant assistance. While these early natural rubber applications seem rudimentary by today's standards, they were paradigm-shifting innovations opening up an entirely new underwater frontier. Humans could finally swim untethered like the marine creatures themselves with a self-contained breathing rig. And rubber's flexibility was the enabler. As the aqualung sparked recreational scuba's meteoric rise, another relatively new polymer, rubber innovation, the neoprene, also joined diving's revolution in the 1940s. Quickly replacing finicky natural rubber for diving masks, neoprene's closed-cell foam structure offered vastly superior thermal insulation for the colder depths, thanks to its trapped gas microbubbles. Not only did the synthetic rubber's neoprene skirt and strap assemblies help create a watertight seal against the face, the softer, more pliable material was infinitely more comfortable than stiff natural rubber for extended wear. Leaky old dive masks now had warm, cozy 20th century upgrades, facilitating longer bottom times. Neoprene's insulating abilities soon saw it adopted for the first functional wetsuits as well. Humans could now better defy the ocean's chill with neoprene's polymer protection while taking full advantage of scuba's untethered underwater access. While neoprene was busy insulating diver cores, yet another versatile polymer was poised to tackle the persisting exposure issues, dodging a diver's extremities. Silicone burst into the scene in the 1960s as the superior solution for pliable mask skirts, comfortable mouthpieces, and even stretchable fin foot pockets. Silicone's hallmark was its incredible softness, matched only by its ability to withstand abrasion, UV, and chemicals that would degrade lesser rubbers. This durability allowed for fitted, watertight seals around the face and feet, with no loss of silky, friction-free comfort over time. Pricier than traditional rubbers, but infinitely superior at interfacing with human skin, silicone rapidly displaced natural rubber for any diving application, demanding consistent softness and resilience against the elements. By the 1970s, it was the undisputed gold standard for top-tier masks, snorkels, and regulators alike. Although silicone became diving's wonder sealant, it was neoprene's insulating might that allowed the iconic wetsuits we know today to take their modern form. As polymer chemistry knowledge advanced, proprietary neoprene foams of varying densities allowed thermal protection to be tuned for any water temperature simply by adjusting thicknesses and trapped gas volume. This specialized bubble structure also gave neoprene excellent flexibility and buoyancy, letting divers retain mobility without feeling like inflexible, saturated pond sponges. From the tropics to the frigid Arctic, custom neoprene rubber suits could now affordably insulate any diver. While some eco-minded companies continue experimenting with more sustainable, plant-based rubber alternatives like Ulex, today, neoprene's unbeatable insulation to flexibility ratio keeps it the overwhelming wetsuit material of choice for serious cold water divers prioritizing performance. So there you have it, my rubber-hearted crew. A true underwater world revolution catalyzed by rubber's almost miraculous versatility and evolving formulations. Each new polymer breakthrough, from the initial Cousteau-Gagnon air regulator to silicone skirts and proprietary neoprene foams, systematically eradicated prior constraints that had shackled humanity to the surface. No longer were divers tethered uncomfortably to bulky metal helmets and held back from deep immersion by cumbersome canvas exposure suits. Through rubber's flexibility, chemical resistance, and insulating abilities, suddenly the entire ocean became an accessible, breathable realm to be plundered for knowledge, resources, and simple human wanderlust. And even today's innovations in sustainable, plant-based rubber substitutes and ever higher performance compounds are fueling diving technology's next evolution. After over a century of steady, synergistic progress alongside rubber engineering, the underwater frontier remains oceanic for those daring enough to keep descending into its bounties. So pause for a deep breath and appreciate the humble elastomer heroes. Rubber's stretchy resilience literally opened for us the entire alien universe lurking beneath the waves. I'd call that an epic underwater achievement worthy of rubber's most elite divers. Who's ready to take the plunge again soon? Don't forget to bounce that like button, share and subscribe, and ring that notification bell to stay up to date with all our future episodes. Until next time, this is Mari signing off. Stay safe, stay informed, and stay rubbery.